In this example, we're going to look at an isothermal continuous stirred tank reactor that is used for two reactions, and these reactions are in series as far as the component X is concerned, and they're in parallel as far as hydrogen is concerned. The rate expressions are given. This is a rate of reaction, moles per volume per time. They're proportional to the H concentration to 0.5 power and the M concentration to the first power. A similar rate expression for the second reaction and the rate constants are given. We only feed components M and H to the reactor, and those concentrations are given here, as well as the volumetric feed rate that's coming into the reactor. And the question is, at the effluent of the reactor, what is the concentration of X divided by the concentration of T? So to do this, we're going to solve mass balances. And the first thing we're going to do is draw a diagram to represent the behavior. And so we have a steady state reactor. We're feeding M and H at a certain volumetric feed rate, 2,000 liters per hour. And then we have all four components leaving. We want to know the concentration of X divided by the concentration of T. And so what we're going to write down are mass balances for all four components. And they're all of the same form. And the form is that steady state, so there's no accumulation. And I'll write for first component M. We have molar flow rate of M coming into the reactor. So it's at this concentration, the molar flow rate is the volumetric flow rate times the concentration. We have molar flow rate of M leaving, so FM leaving here. Again, volumetric flow rate times concentration. Assume the volumetric flow rate is constant. And then, because M is reacting, a negative sign times the rate of reaction per mole times the volume. It's a similar expression for the others. For H, these terms are the same, but now H is reacting in both reactions, so we need both rate expressions. And for X, there's no feed coming in. We have X leaving, and X is involved in two reactions also. So we form X in the first reaction, and we use up X in the second reaction, therefore plus sign for the first reaction, minus for the second. And then likewise for T, there's no T in the feed, and we form T in the second reaction. So these are the four mass balances that we want to solve simultaneously. What we're going to do is simplify, and what we're going to use is the fact that the molar flow rate of M is the volumetric flow rate times the concentration of M. And likewise for the other components. And we make those substitutions, and I'll show it here. So keep in mind, this rate expression is going to be evaluated at the exit conditions of the reactor in a CSTR. And for this, we will end up rewriting it as volume over volumetric flow rate is time in the reactor, residence time. And so we'll have four equations that look similar to this, and we want to solve these simultaneously. So here are the four equations that we're going to solve. And what we want to keep in mind, and we'll look at just the first one, we have concentration in, concentration leaving. The rate expression is K1, the concentration of M, concentration of H to the 1/2 power, then multiplied by tau. So these equations are going to be nonlinear, and the easiest way to solve them is to use a nonlinear equation solver. What we've used is Polymath. We substitute these four equations into Polymath as well as the expressions for R1 and R2 and the parameters. So remember, tau is the volume over the volumetric flow rate. So what I show you here then is the Polymath program. the way we write nonlinear equations in Polymath is to put on the right side the equations that we want to be equal to zero. And then on the left side, we write this f for function. And we put in parentheses one of the variables we're solving for. In this case, we have four equations. We have four variables. It does not matter which one we put in which equation. We're just indicating to the program which of the variables are our unknowns. I've written the rate expressions next here. And then the parameters that we need to solve this, where I've calculated tau as 1,000 divided by 2,000, so it's a half hour. And then for this program to work, we guess what we think the answers are, and then we let it iterate to the final answer. Here are the results. This is the output from Polymath, where I have reduced the number of significant figures that it displays. And it also lists the equations that it solved. This indicates the final value of the function. In other words, how close did it get to zero? And what we're interested in is the concentrations. So concentration of x over the concentration of t is what the problem has asked us to solve for. And 0.718. And in terms of significant figures, we should probably write it as 0.72.